Welcome to the Chortle Awards 2011. Are you looking forward to tonight?
Yeah, it's going to be good, I think.
Seeing lots of friends?
Yeah, I hope so. It's nice to catch up with, you know, proper comedy mates that you've been, you know, doing gigs with since time began, it seems, sometimes. So, yeah, it's nice.
Can you describe your 2010 to us? How good was 2010 for you?
2010 was quite a strange year compared with the previous 3 or 4 years, because I didn't do a sketch show, because I decided I didn't want to do a fourth series. So I did a slightly different sort of show that was all much more based on music and more documentary. So that was quite weird. So the music business is, well, let's just say I might buy them a diary at some point. things seem to get cancelled and reinstated with sort of 10 minutes notice, and you go to Barcelona for a meeting and they phone you up and say, no, we've gone to New York. So it's a little bit tough. And I did a tour, which went really well. I was really happy about that. My first ever really big national tour. So, yeah, it was a completely different year to any year I've had for a good while. So it was quite interesting. A bit stressful sometimes, but good.
Well, it's nice to shake things up and have a new challenge, I guess, all the time.
I think it's definitely good to shake things up, yeah, because otherwise you can just keep taking the safe option and then, you know, before you know it, you're doing something you didn't really set out to do in the first place. So, yeah, it was good.
You can shake things up even more in 2011?
Oh, yeah, definitely. I think you don't have a year like 2010 and not sort of learn a few things and try and, you know, get right where you want to be. So I'm really, last year was really interesting and good and energetic and different, but I sort of feel like this year I really want to, sort of, I can see the way forward properly now.
You've got most of the year already planned out, exactly what you're going to be doing?
Yeah, pretty much.
That must be kind of comforting in a way. It's kind of nice to know what's going to happen.
It is nice, particularly when it's all things that you know you really, really want to do. You know, there's nothing I'm looking at in this year and thinking, oh God, why did I say I'd do that? So yeah, it's really cool, yeah.
I've got to ask, I've been asking everyone about the whole Top Gear Mexico thing, because there's sort of, you know, debate over whether jokes go too far or when, yeah, whether you know they're going too far. Where do you stand on that?
I think the rule was always, for me, was always, as a comedian, you should punch up, not punch down. So my rule was always that I only did A-list people or people who were successful or people, you know, who were achieving what they wanted to achieve. You know, it's probably, it was a flip comment and on their part, and it's all part of the culture of that show. But I still think the rule for me is always punch up, don't punch down. So if you're going to make a joke about someone who's less well off than you, not financially in any way, then I think you just got to have a second look at it, really. But, you know, sometimes funny's funny and it's not always going to please everybody.
Do you know who you're sitting with down there, which table you're on?
I have no idea.
Who would you like to be sitting with? choose one person.
I could choose one person. Frank
one comedian. Oh,
Frank Skinner, yeah.
Absolute Radio DJ, of course.
Well, actually, yes. Do you know what? We couldn't have planned it better. But no, I love Frank. He's I did the pilot of The Bubble with him. So I spent 5 days in a rural house without any telecommunications whatsoever with him and Miranda Hart. And it was like, we always say, it's like we're now a family, the three of us. So, yeah, it's nice to see him.
Really great. Have a good time tonight. Thank you.
Thanks. Cheers. See you later. Bye.